Well, looking really good. I could see some great progress here, particularly when it comes to a theme that is introduced on the cover and carried out throughout the whole brochure. So let's check this out. Yeah, I'm really glad you changed these. You might want to be a little more careful with the spacing. Notice you have a larger gap. I'm going to zoom in so we can see here. A larger gap between the top of the type, and again, we're gonna have to use the bottom of my hand as the pointer. So 2020, I got a gap to the from the white 2020 to the top of the dark blue bar. Then below the 2020, I got a very thin, smaller space. I think those spaces should be even, and if anything, just slightly thicker at the bottom. And they should be the same on all of them. So that's something you're going to have to work out. It would probably be easiest if all the type was on separate boxes, and then in a separate text box, and then it'd probably be about this big. And then once you figured that out with in relation to the dark blue line, I would move all those and duplicate, move and duplicate, and then switch out the text, switch out the colors. That's probably going to be easy because otherwise you're going to be adjusting leading and size and trying to aim them up with the lines. If that's easier for you, do it that way. Both ways will work. But. All right. And I noticed on the cover, the lines do run off the edge of the page. That's awesome. So that's one reason why I might consider letting these run off right here. I noticed that you've done that on some other pages, such as here, and you might want to fix that little edge right there. But you've got them running off right here and at the bottom, running off the tops here, etc. So you may want to do that here. Does it work? Yeah, it could work all lined up and clean like that, but it could also easily run off and tie in to more of the other pages. I'm glad you got a stepping stone in there. Good job. Again, this is the only place where you have the transparency of the blue. So I'm going to encourage you to either put in more use of transparency or just make it a solid. Why? So it matches the rest because it's the only place so it kind of sticks out like that. The type here is kind of tight. I would probably hide this folio. You can do that in InDesign if you hold control and you click on the page that you're on. In this case, well, I'm not sure it'd be page one. You did get the number to move to page one. Good job. So, but folio doesn't necessarily have to be on every single page. And so here, because it's so tight to the type, I'd probably get rid of it. And if you, I can make a video for you about that later if you need to. Here, got a stepping stone. This is looking good. I love the cascade. I go from here to here to here. That's nice. This is working. The only thing I would do here is push the type over. Type touching the edge of the box is technically a typographic error, so something you want to avoid. You use that same kind of approach here and you did it right. So I'd push the type over. I'd probably, I know it's, I'm going crazy, but I'd probably put a stepping stone in there like MI Arts, maybe MI Arts Friends in bold or something, just to do that. I noticed that you have this asterisk indicates a portion of the gift came, blah, blah, blah. But none of these have asterisks. If that's the case, then I'd probably just get rid of this, as there is no asterisk to go along with it. Now, that might be a problem from the original type, so I don't consider this your error or anything, but this is something I'd get rid of if there's no reference, no purpose for it. Here, yeah, I think this is working. This one's improved a lot. I'm really glad. I noticed you lined these up really well. I would probably do the same here. It's so close to being aligned. That, when things are really close to being lined up, you might as well just line them up, because you always want to come across as the one making a choice, not just letting it happen. In other words, is it a mistake or a choice? You always want to communicate it was a choice. And the way you're going to communicate that is by having this line up nicely. Now, of course, the pictures won't line up, but the change in color is not that much from the dark gray to the dark blue. So it's not really going to stand out that much. This one, too, I'd probably do the same thing. I'd use this edge of the photo to pull this out here and the edge of this photo to pull it out there. Then you'd be using more of the page, and it would be larger type. Sure, but we're kind of treating it as a pull quote. And this has stronger entry, stronger focal point, so it's still going to win. But you'll just have a little more alignment. So I think that would be an improvement. Here, I'd probably do two different types of drop stepping stones. Maybe one a drop cap, maybe one first sentence all in bold or something to kind of give them stepping stones. I like your line linking into the line. I do have an idea, because I'm still having a hard time associating this title with all this smaller text. So here's a couple thoughts. Let's give it some more room. We could, instead of using the dark blue line, we could use this gray-blue line and pull it across and link it in right there. Then maybe make this a two-sentence line instead of one across. It would break it into two parts. And then maybe make the totals always in bold and a little bit larger, and particularly the grand total. So people could look at this and because of size, know that they're related. And it would also be a way to say, you know, MI Arts is successful. Look, we're raising money. So making a bigger point of that. You might want to reduce the color of this or change this to white or something. The contrast is just a little on the dull side. Why don't you squint at it and you'll see what I'm talking about. That when you squint, you can see you still have contrast here, still have great contrast here, but the contrast between the black and the dark, or this gray-blue, kind of just fades away. So that's something to be concerned about. Really nice that you gave me some kind of titles to all of these. That's really clever, successful. I'd probably, if I could, make this type stronger. I don't know if I'd make it bold or a little bit larger. I know you're working in a really narrow, calm, and tight space, so I know it's hard, but you know, think about that. Kind of get me from corporate circle to this, then down, 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 down. I like how these are all standing out in bold. And for this page, they might be the right size. You might want to increase the title just 2 points or so, but we'll see. The pledge form, I would probably make that a dotted line, and I'd be tempted to add scissors to it. Maybe just a dotted line would work. Let's see, does it say anything cut around the dotted line? No, it doesn't, but I will send you this file. It's called the Font Tester, and what you do is every keyboard key available on the keyboard. So a lot of different, you know, we usually see all the lowercase and the uppercase and the numbers, some question marks and things like that, but we don't know about all these hidden symbols that are in there. And if you do something like, Zaf Dingbats, for example, you'll find that there's a lot of symbols that could be quite useful. So I'm thinking about this one. I would just copy that, and you could copy it from here and pull it right over to InDesign and paste it in its own text box and rotate it around, and you'd have a pair of scissors right on the dotted line, so there'd be no question. I don't think I'd have the dots here or here. I'd just let it go straight and straight and run off at the bottom. This is nice. I don't know about the blue on either side. I'd probably just enlarge a picture, fill up that space. And then here, Oh no, I said it again. Another stepping stone. And this one, I'd probably drop the type size down to make it smaller and then just go into two columns right here. So you have like a stepping stone intro, a intro paragraph, and then a column and a column of type all related to this. I think that would be very useful. On these, you might want to differentiate a few things. For example, MIR, it should probably be in bold. Maybe the name of the keynote speaker, the name of the whoever's winning these awards and stuff like that. Okay, and then you end up on page 13. Now, is 13 a division of 4? And I would say no. So you're one page over. Well, maybe you are four, because you count that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So, let's see. Well, technically, that's 3.5. So we're off. Yeah, you need to add another page if we're gonna, and maybe I need to make a video to explain it, but just imagine a sheet of 11 by 17. You fold it in half. What do you get? Then that's what this newsletter is printed on. 11 by 17 folded in half. Each sheet becomes 4 8.5 by 11 pages. That's why you need to end up with the total number of pages being divisible by 4. Because, it's all printed on 11 by 17, folded in the middle, stapled in the middle. And that's how newsletters work. So we can't get away with this number of pages. We're going to have to increase it. Or decrease it. So I'll let you decide, but you need a division of 4. But overall, big improvement on last time. Good job.